President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. uplifting the Filipinos' Christmas spirit. In his first Christmas message as the country's president, Marcos reminded the public to focus on the true essence of the holiday, and that is love. Marcos hoped the celebration of Jesus Christ's birth will inspire the people to embody generosity and goodwill. The Marcos family celebrated Christmas Eve in Malacañang based on photos shared by the president's son, Ilocos Norte Representative Sandro Marcos. The president earlier opened the Malacañang grounds to the public and held dawn masses about a week before Christmas. The palace said it received around 21,000 visitors during that period. Heavy rain spoiled Christmas celebrations in parts of the Visayas and Mindanao, leaving at least four people dead. In Misamis Occidental, two people drowned. In Clarín Town, rains also triggered heavy flooding in several other areas, including Ozamis City. The province of Misamis Oriental was also not spared, with Hingoog City now placed under a state of calamity. Over in southern Leyte, two fishermen died while six others were rescued after their fishing boat capsized amid heavy rains and strong waves. Bukidnon, meanwhile, reported heavy flooding in Malaybalay City, with neck-deep waters submerging cars and homes. Several houses in northern Samar were also flooded, and in eastern Samar, some residents had to be evacuated due to the bad weather.
The Philippine Social Welfare Department says it has started relief operations for flood victims in Visayas and Mindanao. The agency says its field offices have distributed food packs to affected residents in Eastern Samar, Misamis Oriental, Misamis Occidental, and Bukidnon.
Now let's get an update on the weather today with PAGASA weather forecaster Raymond Ordinario. He joins us now on the line. Raymond, good morning. Merry Christmas.
Yes, Merry Christmas, Mike. And this is our weather for the next 24 hours. It's still the shielding affecting Visayas, bringing cloudy skies with scattered to widespread rain showers and thunderstorms over the eastern Visayas, Surigao del Norte, and Dinagat Island. Meanwhile, cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms expected over northern Mindanao, Zamboanga Peninsula, Basilan, Sulu, Tawi-Tawi, Palawan, and the rest of Visayas and Caraga. Meanwhile, the northeast monsoon is still affecting Luzon area, bringing cloudy skies with rains over Cagayan Valley, Cordillera, Aurora, Quezon, and the Bicol region. Here in Metro Manila and the rest of Luzon, we're going to expect a generally fair weather condition apart from some light rains. While the rest of Mindanao, we're going to expect fair weather condition aside from isolated rain showers and thunderstorms. The temperature range here in Metro Manila from 23 to 29 degrees Celsius. Meanwhile, in Baguio, around 12 to 20, and in Tagaytay is around 18 to 26 degrees Celsius. Mike, because of the surge of the northeast monsoon, we have gale warning raised over the seabirds of Batanes, Cagayan, Babuyan Island, Isabela, Aurora, Ilocos Norte, Ilocos Sur, La Union, Pangasinan, Zambales, Quezon, Polillo Island, Camarines Norte, Camarines Sur, Catanduanes, Masbate, Burias Island, Albay, Sorsogon, Romblon, Marinduque, Northern and Eastern Samar, Samar, Leyte, Negros Provinces, Guimaras, Iloilo, Antique, Aklan, Bohol, Cebu, Dinagat Island, Siargao, Bucas Grande Island, Surigao del Sur, Batangas, Oriental and Occidental Mindoro, Lubang Island, Palawan, including Calamian, Cuyo, and Carayaan Island. So that's why we're still advising our fisher folks and those who have small sea crabs not to venture out on these seabirds, because we're expecting a high wave that might reach up to 5.5 meters. And in the next 3 days, we're not expecting any tropical cyclone development within the area of responsibility. And that's the latest from the Weather Forecasting Center of PAGASA, Raymond Ordinario reporting.
Raymond, just want to ask, until when can we expect the cool weather here in Metro Manila?
Maybe the cool weather in Metro Manila, we're going to expect it until the New Year's Eve or until next week, that the surge of the northeast monsoon will going to prevail over Luzon area.
All right. Thank you so much for that update, Raymond Ordinario from PAGASA.
Meanwhile, many families flock to parks and other tourist destinations in Metro Manila on Christmas Day. Sites like Luneta Park, Manila Zoo, and the Quezon Memorial Circle saw crowds of visitors with COVID restrictions now eased. Metro Manila police say the Christmas celebration in the capital region, including the 9 days in Bangabi or dawn masses, was generally peaceful.